Hello, and welcome to the second episode of the second season of The Disneyland Show. I'm your host, MeeGurgle13/. Today in beautiful Sunnyside, California at the Disneyland Resort, we're going to be talking about the best way to avoid the crowds at Disneyland. If you are new to the channel, make sure to smash the subscribe button for more awesome videos in the future. And without further ado, roll the intro. Start. I just want to say that this route actually works really well for me when I go to Disneyland and I want to go on all the big and exciting rides at Disneyland. Not exactly all the big rides, but like rides that have Fast Pass and are exciting to go on. With this route, I usually finish Disneyland at around 4:00 p.m. that time on a very busy day. Like on a busy day. But this list does not include small rides like Buzz Lightyear or Nemo. Like for example. I just don't include those rides because usually the lines are really long and then it's not really worth it to go on like when it's busy, like not when it's like not crowded. When it's not crowded, then totally go on it. But when it is busy, you kind of don't want to go on those rides unless of course it's like your favorite ride. This route also includes where to eat lunch at and some snacks along your way if you get hungry. I mean, like you get hungry when you're walking all that time at Disneyland and like there's churros right there, like come on now. Of course, this route is totally optional, so you don't have to do it. Also, I found this route to be the best for me, but it may not be the best for you or depending on the day. Like I just found this route and I've done it many times, and then I've actually given this route to my friends and my family, and they have actually said that when they followed it was like the best experience at Disneyland they've ever had, especially on a summer busy day. So I thought why not I share that with the YouTube community. And if you do have a better Disneyland route than this, then please email me. Don't hesitate, email me right away if you guys have a better route, because that would be awesome. Like I want to know what that is. So anyway guys, let us get started in the video. Alright guys, so I have a map in front of you and I'm going to direct you exactly where to go and everything like that. So first, and then this map will be uploaded, I will scan it and I will take a picture of it for you guys. Take a picture and upload it to my website so you can download and print off the map if you want, so you can bring it to your next Disneyland trip. So basically, you're going to want to come through Disneyland, so make sure to get there bright and early. You're going to want to make sure to get there bright and early, especially on a summer day, because that's what everyone else is doing. So what you're going to do is you're going to go, and then you're going to move directly to Tomorrowland. That's where you want to go. And then you're going to get fast passes quickly for Star Tours, which is on this side. Star Tours fast passes are on this side, not on this side. So get a fast pass real quick over here. You're going to get a fast pass, okay? And then you're going to go directly to Space Mountain, and you're going to get in line for Space Mountain. Once you're in line for Space Mountain, you get on the ride, everything. The ride's so much fun and everything. Your fast pass for Star Tours should be up. So then you're just going to go back the way you came and go on to Star Tours. Alright? So after Star Tours, you're then going to go all the way. Now I know this route is actually a little bit more of a walking one, but it's worth it when it's in the summer. You're gonna go all the way across all the way to Adventureland and get a fast pass for Indiana right over there. Okay? So once you get a fast pass for Indiana, then you're gonna head all the way back to where you came from, and there's like a little coffee cart over here, and if you're like thirsty or something like or hungry, you can get a quick little snack over there and it's pretty good. And then you're gonna go all the way and you're gonna head over to Matterhorn. The line usually starts over here, and then you're gonna get on Matterhorn. After you get on Matterhorn, guess what guys? You're gonna go back to Adventureland and get on Indiana Jones. After Indiana Jones, I would suggest going this way and going to Frontierland, getting a fast pass for Thunder Mountain quickly, and then by that time it's around lunchtime. And so then there's this Mexican restaurant right here, and you just go over there and you can eat and enjoy. But by that time, when you leave, you're going to be full. You're not really going to want to go on a fast ride. So then, but your fast passes should be available by that time. So after your fast passes are up, you're going to go to New Orleans and you're going to go directly to the Haunted Mansion. Get a fast pass, which the fast pass is over here. You're going to get a fast pass, and then you're going to come back and then get in line for Pirates, which is right here. Get in line for Pirates, hop on Pirates, it should be fine, it should be like a 20 minute wait, usually goes pretty quick. After Pirates, head on to Thunder Mountain. I know this is getting a little complicated here. Then go on to Thunder Mountain. After you go on to Thunder Mountain, your fast pass for Haunted Mansion should be up. So you go back to Haunted Mansion. I know it's like, what the what? Go back to Haunted Mansion, get on Haunted Mansion. But before you get on Haunted Mansion, you should have fast passes before you get on Haunted Mansion. You're going to want to go to Critter Country and get a fast pass for Splash Mountain if you want to go on Splash Mountain. I mean, like, some people don't like Splash Mountain, so that's totally up to you. So then you can get a fast pass for Splash Mountain, come back, go on Haunted Mansion. By that time, usually it's Splash Mountain time, or like 5:15, 6:15. And by this time, when you go on Haunted Mansion, it's about 4 o'clock. So by that time, you can get snacks and do anything you want, and you still have, like, depending on when the park closes, and usually the park closes at, like, 11 or 12 o'clock at night in the summer, you still have, like, 8 hours. So you still have basically 6 to 8 hours to get to do whatever you want. So at this time, you then go on all the small rides. Now, all the small rides are actually, like, not as packed as they were because all the little kids are asleep, and, yeah, so basically this is the best time to go on all the little rides. If you want to go on Winnie the Pooh, you can go on Winnie the Pooh. If you want to go on the Jungle Cruise, you can go on the Jungle Cruise. The Jungle Cruise is usually a 25 to 35 minute wait by this time. If you want to go to Fantasyland, go to Fantasyland. Now, you probably meant seeing that by this, I haven't hit any of the rides in here, and I haven't hit any of the rides over here, and I haven't hit any of the rides over here, and then I did not do Autopia. So I know that that's like a shock, but like these are all the big rides. I basically hit all the big rides at Disneyland, and it was before 4 o'clock, so now you have time to actually hit all those rides. The best time, if you want to really ride Peter Pan, the best time to ride Peter Pan is during the fireworks. Get in line. There should be a line somewhere, like, I don't think it's by the teacups. Yeah, no, there's a line somewhere over here because they close off this part, so there's a line over here, and you're going to want to get in that line for Peter Pan ASAPPP. Once you're in line, usually it's about a 30-minute wait until the fireworks are cleared and everything, and then you can get released into Peter Pan. So basically that's it, guys. That's basically the whole shabam. That's basically the best route, personally, for me to go on. If you guys want to re-ride any rides, like, again, after that ride, just do it. Get more fast passes. Like, by that time, you can still get more fast passes. Probably not for Space Mountain, but mostly you can probably still get a fast pass for Indiana, Thunder Mountain, Splash Mountain, like any, and depending on the day, some people don't go on Splash Mountain because it's too hot. I mean, not too hot, too cold. So some people actually, like, sometimes you can just walk right on Splash Mountain, like if it's late at night, you can just walk right on because it's night, it's cold, no one wants to go on it. So that is the route. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and let us outro this video. Anyway, guys, that was my special route on how to avoid the crowds at Disneyland. It really does work, guys. Again, family, I've given this route to family and friends, and they said that they've had the best experience at Disneyland because of it, and they said they got on all the rides quickly, easy, fast, like it wasn't like, and the day was actually enjoyable because I avoided all the crowds. This route actually avoids all the crowds, so this route was really helpful, like no joke. So I encourage you to try it, like I really do, like just, if you do try it, just get back to me and say, Kate, like, that really worked, or Kate, that didn't work for me, or something like that, because I really want your feedback on this. But anyway, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to leave a like, and if you are new to the channel, make sure to sprinkle the videos over that subscribe button, because you're going to want to stay tuned for next week, where we talk about the 5 best sweet treats at Disneyland. But anyway, guys, I'm your host, Kate/MeMiracle13, and I will see you guys later. I'm out!